Alright, what's going on, Ranking Finder here, and today we're gonna be ranking each and every one of the perks that are in Killing Floor 2. But yeah, I just have to say this in the beginning before I offend someone. If I pick a perk and put him, I don't know, where you don't expect him to be, don't rage at me, because this is only my opinion and I'm judging this, how should I say, ranking from my gameplay experience and how effective this perk is. So yeah, these perks are gonna be ranked for a 6-player Hell on Earth. That's usually how I rank everything in this game, because that's how it should be ranked. You don't rank a perk for like hard or normal. So yeah, 6-player Hell on Earth, how they act, are they good? That's what we're gonna be discussing today. But yeah, this video was requested for a very long time, and since I don't have anything else to do for this quote-unquote Christmas update, I might as well just go and, you know, start doing something with the perks. I mean, perk guides are gonna soon follow this thing. But yeah, this is how it's gonna work. I'm just gonna grab a perk, gonna like move it around, but first of all, I'm just gonna tell you why I think it's good or bad or mediocre or just something, and I'm just gonna like plop him either here, maybe in the F, and maybe in the S, or maybe in the D. But yeah, if you're gonna be like, I don't know, for instance, a survivalist main, you're probably gonna think the survivalist is S tier, and I most likely don't think that, so if I put him somewhere else, don't be mad. Just tell me in the comments, or should I say, just say in the comments why I'm wrong. But yeah, if you're gonna make a list in the comments, do tell me on why you think it's at that tier. So yeah, let's start off with the Berserker, one of the most powerful perks in the game, but not the best ones, in my opinion. So yeah, the Berserker is all about close combat, and usually it does really freaking well. But I mean, there are those times where the Berserker is just annihilated. Maybe you get like over cocky, maybe you just can't get out of a single situation, maybe you just like misjudge a situation. So yeah, the Berserker is gonna be in the A tier, because I mean, it is a good ass freaking perk. One of my favorites, I love it to death, but I don't think it's S tier. But yeah, this is not gonna be a full on perk guide, I'm just gonna like put these things in, tell you like a little bit about what I think about the perk, and that's how we're gonna be rolling. So the next one is Ede Commando. But yeah, Ede Commando, a lot of people give him hate, I give him praise, because if I'm a level 25 perk on multiplayer, and if the commander knows what the hell he's doing, yeah, he's gonna be extending slow motion as much as possible, which allows me to use my level 25 skills. But I mean, the only downside of the commando is it doesn't have any survival ability, but for the team, yeah, this perk is gonna go in the A tier. And next up we got Ada Support. So yeah, the support, what is it and what is it good for? I mean, it's in the name, it's the support, it gives the team ammo, it gives the team armor, it can repair doors. Especially good if you have like a demo on your team and if the demo knows what the hell he's doing. Yeah, he's gonna be door trapping the doors, and once that door breaks, yeah, the support can just go repair it and rinse and repeat. And on top of that, if you're a level 25 support, yeah, you're gonna be carrying 20 kilograms. That means basically you're never gonna run out of ammo, and on top of that, the support does a lot of damage. Now, the only downside about the support is that, you know, the perk is alright at surviving by its own. It even has like the double barrel, you can like jump over things and shit like that. But occasionally the perk gets, I don't know, in like a very awkward state. And sometimes you just find yourself like reloading all the slugs, you know, just like reloading when you're supposed to shoot something. So I'm just gonna put them in the A tier. Okay, next up we got the demo. Now, arguably this is one of my favorite perks. A lot of people hate them because it's, you know, shakes their screen and shit like that. But for me personally, I mean, I don't mind. I don't take Killing Floor that seriously to, you know, complain about that shit, but yeah, I do like the freaking demo. But yeah, what can the demo do? Like I mentioned before, it can door trap doors, it can keep a lot of Zeds at bay, you know, it can kill them really fast, it's like a good crowd control perk, and on top of that, it kills Fleshbones and Skrakes very freaking reliably. Now, the only downside of the demo is it reloads all the time. So if you get cornered, yeah, you're most likely gonna be destroyed. I mean, it does have like that active armor once you get down to like 5%, but that usually doesn't save you for that long. I mean, fair enough, I clutched like a lot of times with that. But I mean, generally, once that happens, yeah, that is gonna be following quite soon. So yeah, just gonna put this thing in the A tier. Okay, next up we got the Firebug. But yeah, the Firebug, this thing does have a lot of controversy in the whole Killing Floor community, and I kind of understand why, but at the same time, I mean, dudes, this game is not competitive, you're killing AI. So yeah, if you like miss a clot here and there, that's not gonna be like that detrimental, but I mean, in the spring update in 2019, yeah, this perk got tweaked a little bit and now it doesn't stumble Zeds that much. But I mean, this perk is the master of, how should I say, trash killing. But I mean, if you have like a commando on your team, yeah, sometimes they're gonna mess him over. But yeah, usually Farbuck players are gonna be there when you don't need them. So I'm just gonna put this perk in the C tier. Now, don't get me wrong, the Farbug, it is a very cool perk, it can handle its own. From time to time, it has some unique skills on him. But I mean, overall, the team doesn't really need him. Now, the next perk we have is the Gunslinger. Now, the Gunslinger, for me personally, if you have some aim, yeah, this is one of the best perks in the game, because it can handle pretty much everything. Now, the survival ability on him is not that great, but I mean, the amount of damage per second this thing actually puts out, yeah, that kind of doesn't really matter. And on top of that, it is a fast perk, so it can run away from certain situations. Now, the only problem with the Gunslinger is sometimes ammunition, but I mean, if you have like a support on your team, yeah, most likely you're not gonna be running out of freaking ammo. So yeah, this is gonna be a bold statement, but I am gonna put them at the S tier, because I mean, let's face it, yeah, accurate perks in Killing Floor 2 are one of the best perks in the freaking game. Okay, next perk we have right here is the Medic. So yeah, the Medic, I mean, a team, if it's good enough, it can go without a medic, but I mean, usually if you're gonna be playing public, yeah, not everyone's gonna be, you know, those MLG esports ready players that, you know, can kill Zeds. So yeah, the medic, if you know how to heal and if you're like fast about them, yeah, this perk is one of the best. Now, fair enough, the medic, it does have a lot of survival ability, it can heal the team, it can buff the team, it can, you know, throw some healing grenades to heal people from afar, it has darts. Recently it had the HRG railgun thing. So yeah, overall the medic is, safe to say, this perk is very freaking reliable. And that's why I'm gonna put him on the S tier. But yeah, initially I was gonna put the medic in the A tier, because, like I said, a lot of times people don't need the medic, but I mean, as far as I'm seeing, whenever I'm playing like a public match, you know, 6-player Hell on Earth, obviously, yeah, a medic is sometimes the way to go, so I'm just gonna put them at the S tier, because it can change a game from being a loss to a win. Okay, the next perk we have right here is the Sharpshooter. Now, the Sharpshooter, like the Gunslinger, yeah, it requires accuracy to be effective. Now, the Sharpshooter has a lot of other things. It has very powerful weapons, it has a lot of skills that boost the damage on the perk. And on top of that, it has freeze grenades. Now, the freeze grenades are so freaking good on the Sharpshooter, and sometimes you, like, need them. You know, if there's like a crowd of skrakes and other random shenanigans coming at your ass, you just like throw that freaking nade and everything is frozen and you can just pinpoint your targets and kill them. So yeah, people are usually gonna put them here at the B, but since I know what the hell I'm doing with the Sharpshooter, yeah, I'm gonna put them on the S tier, because like I said, if you have aim, yeah, this perk is phenomenal. Okay, next up we have, oh, I can just put this thing at the F, right? But nope, I'm just gonna put them somewhere else, because this is gonna be my honest, you know, perk tier list. Now, if you guys watch my videos for a very long time, you're gonna know that I despise this survivalist, and I don't despise him for, you know, what he can do in the game. I just despise it because it's, I mean, at the end of the day, just pointless as hell. Because if you want to be a medic, just play the medic. If you want to be a support, play the support. If you want to be, I don't know, a demo, be a demo. But yeah, this perk, I mean, it is fun to play, right? You can be like whatever the hell you want to be. Just 50% worse, because you don't get like any bonuses pretty much. But I mean, if you do pick the right weapons for this perk, and if you know what the hell you're doing with them, yeah, it is, at the end of the day, still kind of cool, but that's why I'm just gonna put him at the B, because he's not on par with, you know, the Berserker Commando, stuff like that. He's definitely not S tier, and throwing him on the C tier, I mean, I could theoretically just put him at C, because that's like straight in the middle. Maybe I'm gonna do that, because it's just mediocre at the end of the day. Okay, now the last perk we have right here is the SWAT. Now, is the SWAT gonna be S tier, A tier, B tier, C tier, D, E, F? I don't know. Wherever should I put this thing? Okay, now hear me out, this is gonna sprout a lot of controversy. I can just see it already. I mean, maybe, you know, already these ones are gonna sprout a lot of controversy, but that aside. So yeah, the SWAT for me, I mean, it is somewhat decent at killing trash, but I mean, if you want to kill trash, just pick Farbug, pick the commando, pick the support, pick the demo, and that's essentially what the SWAT's main purpose actually is. I mean, he is supposed to be like a tanky perk, but I mean, at the end of the day, three flesh wounds are gonna be clapping you, yeah, you're gonna be pretty much dead, so not much tankiness there. I mean, maybe with the riot shield, I'm gonna put him somewhere else in this tier list, but as of right now, he's just gonna go at the D. Yep, I said that SWAT is the worst perk in Killing Floor 2. I mean, I shouldn't say the worst, I'm just gonna say the most useless for the team, because, I mean, he does clear trash. You are right. I know he does clear trash. But, I mean, all of these perks can kill the trash. And these perks can kill trash. I mean, the medic can also kill trash. So yeah, this is my tier list, and if you guys have any different suggestions, or you just want to like put something somewhere else, be sure to do that in the comments and tell me why you would do that. And please, you have to be playing a 6-player Hell on Earth, because if you're gonna be playing on hard or suicidal and just solo, yeah, that's not gonna be like an accurate representation. Because like I said in the beginning, yeah, this tier list is ranked for a 6-player Hell on Earth. But yeah, anyway, this is pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and like I said, comment down below if you think I'm right. Am I wrong? Just don't dislike the video, because I put survivalist at C and not the F. But yeah, with that being said, see you guys next episode. Adios.